Hello and welcome to Newsclick. I'm Sumedha, and today we're bringing you a glimpse of some of the most important stories that we report about at Newsclick. On its second day, the industrial workers' strike has been declared extremely successful because it brought the nation to a standstill. After protesting outside their factories yesterday, the workers from across the city gathered in Mandi House to march to the Parliament Street to make their voices heard. Sloganeering in solidarity, the workers asserted that there is no question of a government that seeks to dilute their rights and trample their interests. The workers also questioned that what is the point of working if they can't feed their families and save their lives. There is never a dull day when you're a BJP spokesperson. Shahnawaz Hussain ko hi dekh lo, aaj tak ke studio mein chale gaye prime time debate par. Par unhe shayad cashless economy ka matlab samajh nahi aaya. He confused it with Paytm.
HAL ke CMD R Madhavan ne khud ye kaha ki our cash in hand is in negative. Aur hame 1000 crore as overdraft lena
padega. Economy wale hain sahab. Ha? Cashless economy wale log hain log.
After R. Madhavan, who's the chairperson and the managing director of HAL, made this claim, the claims kicked up a storm. From Twitterati to newsrooms, everyone went crazy. But the joke of the day was on the BJP spokesperson. A 5-judge constitutional bench of the Supreme Court is all set to hear the Ram Janmabhoomi issue on the 10th of January. The bench will comprise of Chief Justice of India, Ranjan Gogoi, Justices S.A. Bobde, N.V. Ramana, U.U. Lalit and D.Y. Chandrachur. The Ayodhya case has a very strong religious as well as a political link to it. Right before the BJP came to power in 2014, it had promised its voters that it will build the Ram Temple at the Ayodhya site. Amidst all the political rhetoric and sentiments running high, the BJP has assured that it will wait for the judicial processes to get over. The BJP government is facing a major backlash from other opposition parties over doling out 10% of quota for the economically marginalized upper castes. The opposition is calling this a major election gimmick. The DMK on Tuesday registered a strong opposition urging the Tamil Nadu government to adopt a resolution against the centre. To understand this better, it's important to note that the Supreme Court bars the reservation to about 50%. The Constitution of India also provides reservations on the basis of education and social backwardness. To provide this additional quota, it would mean that legislative action is needed, which would mean that constitutional amendments need to take place. There is widespread suspicion amongst Dalits, Adivasis and OBC communities that the BJP is abandoning any plan to secure their rights with the announcement of this move. In international news, the extreme right-wing leader of Brazil, Jair Bolsonaro, assumed office on January 1st. In the few days that he took office, Bolsonaro and his government has already started targeting the LGBTQ community, indigenous people, and has also lowered minimum wage. In his presidential address, he reaffirmed campaign promises such as civilian gun possession, the privatization of agribusinesses, and public companies. In his address, he also went on to say that Brazil was now free from socialism. He wants to rescue the family, restore Judeo-Christian traditions, as well as combat gender ideology. However, now that Bolsonaro is president, his words are not just threats. They mean decrees, policies and laws that can actually strip the Brazilian people of their rights, lands and public companies. That's all that we have for you today on this episode of the Daily Roundup. Follow these stories and many more by logging on to our website www.newsclick.in. Subscribe to us on YouTube and follow us on Facebook.